Hey everyone, I hope you are staying healthy and staying safe out there. As I am contemplating life in quarantine, finding a better balance between doing and being, I am thinking a little bit about habits or routines that serve me, and which ones do I want to, you know, release, which ones do I want to reprogram into my life and hopefully take with me when all of this is over. And the great news, and part of why I'm looking at this right now, is because times when we've had when you have a dramatic change are actually ideal times to make a change in habits. And so, looking at The Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg, he talks about a habit loop. And so there's a cue and a routine and a reward in almost every habit. So there's a trigger. So maybe it's anxiety that makes you reach out for the bag of potato chips because they have all the answers. They really do. And then you have a reward, right? You get a bit of hit of dopamine, your cortisol levels go down for a minute, and then that cycle repeats. And you keep doing that over and over, and eventually that becomes your pattern, your habit. There are also some keystone habits, habits that actually impact a whole series of habits, almost have a domino effect. And some of those big ones are exercise, or meditation, planning, sleep, and creating routines, particularly morning and night routines. Again, another reason why right now is a really great time to take a look at this, because our lives have just been turned upside down. Schedules are completely different. We're not going the same place. We're not doing the same things. Our patterns have been majorly interrupted, and I know, or disrupted in many cases. And sometimes that's challenging. And the good news is it's also a time to sort of come at it with a clean slate. Hey, you can create anything you want. Your patterns have just been turned upside down, so you have to recreate new ones. So why not recreate better ones? So if you're looking to change a habit, take a look at, first of all, what is it? And what is your cue? What's your trigger? If it's stress, what do you go to? What's your go-to thing? And then what's the reward? And really identify what those are. And then look and see what's another thing you could do. Replace that negative one. And how can you make sure you get the reward that you're ultimately seeking with the original cue to begin with, or the original trigger? If you're anxious and you're looking for a relief, how else can you find that relief? So you want to try to substitute that. Also looking at some of those keystone habits like exercise. Exercise can change everything. Not only is it great for you right now because it improves your immune system, but it also can change the whole dynamic of your day. It can make you more focused. It can make you feel better. Choose better foods. It'll help you sleep better. It'll make you more productive. It really has that domino effect. And so looking at some of those big keystone habits in your life right now could be a really effective and timely change. And also, looking at those keystone things, also looking at your habit loop and what you might want to change, creating new routines, productivity model will not necessarily look at changing habits, but creating routines that serve you. So that's a really positive way of looking at it. And even if you're in a space right now where you're wanting to do less and be more, that's all great. And there might still be some benefit to finding some routine that still supports you in a way that keeps you healthy and keeps you feeling optimistic and fulfilled. And so if you do some exercise in the morning or meditate in the morning and create like a timeline for yourself, when I first get up, I'm gonna do this and then this and then this and then this. And if you set that routine up for yourself, you're more likely to A, achieve that, and B, fulfill the rest of the things that you're wanting in your life, whatever that is right now. So looking at it that way, flipping the script, looking at different gains that you'll get from it, finding support systems, whether it's a friend that you want to challenge yourself with, or a coach or a supportive group, whichever it is that really will help you stick and go with it. Keeping record of it is also really a great thing. I remember Seinfeld used to say he wanted to work on his jokes, so he would write a joke every day and he would mark it in his thing. He would have a red line on each date, and he didn't want to break the habit because he didn't want the red line to be broken. So, you know, creating some kind of a visual for you. Also visualizing yourself in this new routine that serves you better is a really great way of programming it into your mind. And then repeating. And if you fall, get back up and make it happen tomorrow or even later. So here are a couple positive ways to look at this time in isolation of creating routines that really empower us, serve us, make us healthier, happier, and ultimately flourish more. So continue on this journey. I hope you're finding deep and meaningful things. It's a great time to also reflect. And I hope you're finding productivity if that's what you're in quest of. And if you're looking to change some routines, try those steps below. Okay, talk to you soon. Go out and shine.